keeping us away.
You want to make something out of it?
Jack Dempsey on the orphanage.
Oh, my goodness! Oh, my goodness! Oh, you're on that fight! And I'm getting all free all night! Oh, my goodness! Oh, my goodness!
I got all of you! Now go back to sleep!
It's all right, Molly. Annie's here.
It was my mama, Annie. We was riding on the ferry boat, and she was holding me up to see all the big ships. And then she was walking away, waving, and I couldn't find her no more. Any place.
Blo. It was only a dream, honey. Now you gotta go back to sleep. It's after 3 o'clock.
Annie, read me your note.
Again? Sure, Molly.
Here it comes again.
Please take good care of our little darling. Her name is Annie.
She was born on October 28th. We will be back to get her soon.
We have left half the silver locket around her neck and kept the other half.
So that when we come back for her, you'll know that she's our baby.
Annie, what are you doing?
Running away!
Oh!
never coming for me, so I gotta go find them.
Annie, you're crazy. Miss Hannigan will catch you.
And give you the paddle.
I don't care. I'm getting out of here. Okay. I'm ready. Go now. Wish me luck.
Good luck.
Gotcha! I heard you, brat.
I always hear you.
Now get up. I said get up!
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Now, what do you say? What do you say?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
Rotten orphan.
I am not an orphan. My mother and father left a note saying they love me and they were coming back for me.
Well, that was 1922, and this is 1933. All right, you get in there. Get up. Get up! And put them things away. Come on, up and at 'em. Get the lead out. Rise and shine. Get up. Medicine.
You must be very sick.
All right, now for this one, shenanigans. You'll scrub this floor and strip them beds for the laundryman.
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
No! And you get down on your knobby little knees and clean this dump until it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building. All right, get to work. Now! Why any kid would want to be an orphan, I'll never know.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life for us.
Steady treat and
we get treats.
Steady kisses and
we get kicks. It's a hard knock life. Got no folks to speak of, so it's a hard knock life.
Yeah!
Good morning, children.
Good morning, Miss Hannigan!
Well?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
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 You! What are you doing in there?
Nothing!
Get her out of there! Get her out! Oh. Oh. You! Your days are numbered! This morning! Oh. Yay! You get cold mush! Yeah! And after your mush, you'll go to your sewing machines. There's an order of dresses you'll finish today if you have to work straight through until midnight.
Yes, Miss
Hannigan. All right, line up. Oh, hands.
Laundry! Laundry man! Morning, kids. Clean sheets once a month, whether you need them or not.
Morning, bundles.
Hey, 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 Aggie. How's the prettiest gal south of 14th Street?
Ah, bundles, still full of the same old malarkey.
Oh, Aggie, why can't I ever get to first base with you?
I'm saving it for my wedding night.
Ah.
Now get out of here with that damn laundry.
Okay. So long, gorgeous. Merry Christmas!
Oh, yeah. Merry Christmas, bundles. La, 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 la. You call this place clean, Annie? Place is like a pigsty, Annie. Annie, where is that Annie? What do you mean Annie ain't here?
She just went with Mr. Bundles.
In the laundry bag.
Bundles! Police!
She got away, but we're gonna have to pay.
Gonna get our face slapped. Gonna get our knuckles wrapped. It's a hard knock life.
Yes, it is.
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 It's a hard knock life.
Apples? Hey, apples, two for a nickel.
Hey, mister, could you donate an apple to the orphans' picnic?
Yeah, sure, kid, why not? Nobody's buying them anyway.
Gee, thanks, mister.
Say, kid, when is the orphans' picnic?
Soon as I take a bite.
Nab this mutt back there in the alley. Get in there.
Good. There's supposed to be a whole bunch of them running wild over to Astor Place. Come on, Charlie.
There's one they didn't get. Come here. Poor boy. They're after you, ain't they? Well, they're after me, too. But don't worry. I ain't gonna let them get you or me. I'll take care of you. And everything's gonna be fine. For the both of us. If not today, well... The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just take up my chin and grin and say, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're always a day away.
Hey, you little girl, come here.
Yes, officer?
That dog there, ain't I seen him running around the neighborhood? Ain't he a stray?
A stray? Oh, no, officer, he's my dog.
Your dog, huh? So what's his name?
His name is Sandy, right? That's it, Sandy. I call him Sandy, see, because of his nice sandy color.
Sandy color. So let's see him answer to his name.
Answer? You mean when I call him?
Right, when you call him by his name. Sandy?
You see, I was just calling him, but sometimes...
Call him!
Sandy? Here, boy, Sandy? Come here, Sandy! Come here, Sandy! Come here! Good Sandy. Good old Sandy.
Well, maybe he is your dog. But the next time you take him out, I want to see him on a leash and with a license. Or else he goes to the pound and they put him to sleep. You understand?
Yes, sir. I understand. On a leash and with a license.
Now get along with you before you catch your death of cold in
oh,
this
I
weather.
Oh, I don't mind the weather. And I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely. I just stick up my chin and grin and say, the sun will come out tomorrow.
Some more wood for the penthouse.
Hey, Eddie, can you give me a hand?
Sure thing, beautiful.
Hey, look at this. We made Collier's again. In Hoover they trusted, and now they are busted by Westbrook Peglet. Thousands of once affluent Americans are today living in makeshift towns called Hoovervilles.
Hey, how'd it go today, Al? 7 million people in this town, and I can't sell one lousy apple.
And in New York City alone, there are more than a dozen Hoovervilles. Riverside Drive, Central Park. Hey, here we are, 59th Street Bridge!
Today we're living in a shanty. Today we're scrounging for a meal.
Today I'm stealing coal for fires. Who knew?
I used to winter in the tropics.
I spent my summers at the shore.
I used to throw away the papers.
We don't anymore. We'd like to thank you, Herbert Hoover, for really showing us the way. We'd like to thank you, Herbert Hoover. You made us what we are today. Prosperity was round the corner, the cozy cottage built for two. In this blue heaven that you gave us, yes, we're turning blue. They offered us Ascot and Hoover. We paid attention and we chose. Not only did we pay attention, repay through the nose. In every pot he set a chicken, but Herbert Hoover he forgot. Not only don't we have the chicken, we ain't got the pot. Hey, Herbie,
you left behind the grateful nation.
So Herb, our hats are off to you.
Come down and have a little stew.
Come down and share some Christmas dinner. Ho, 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 be sure to bring the missing stew. We got the turkey for our stuffing. Why don't we stuff you? We'd like to thank you, Herbert Hoover, for really showing us the way. You dirty rat, you! What we are today. Come and get it, Herb.
Excuse me, folks, but did any of you here leave a red-headed kid at an orphanage 11 years ago?
Madame et Monsieur, dinner is served.
Soup is on!
Hey, kids, you hungry?
Nah.
Nah? Okay.
But my dog is.
Come on, kid, and bring your dog, too.
I'll get her a cup.
Here, she can use mine.
Gee, thanks, lady.
Call me Sophie.
I'm Annie, and this is Sandy.
Well, pleased to meet you. And you, too. Go ahead, honey. Eat your fill.
Thanks. Yeah.
It's the spot, don't it?
Hey, kid. What are you doing out alone this time of night?
I'm looking for my mom and dad. They're lost.
Lost? And how long have you been looking for them?
About 11 years.
Now that's lost.
Don't worry, kid. You'll find them.
You bet I'll find them.
Oh, now that's something I haven't heard since 1928.
What?
Optimism.
What do we got to be optimistic about? Look at us. Life's a nightmare.
Well, you gotta have a dream.
Traffic rattling overhead all night.
To wake you up from your nightmare.
Empty pockets.
At least you got pockets.
Freezing fingers.
Lucky you got them empty pockets.
Newspapers for blankets.
You can read in bed.
You should have been a politician. You really got away.
We should have had you on the ballot.
Yeah.
The mother, guys, is for the birds.
All right, move along, all you bums out of here.
We're
tearing down this junk pile now.
All of you,
so I used to pay a lot of money.
Come on, Jimmy, ride.
Leave me alone, I live here.
The kid got away, come on.
For the month. What do you got there? What have you got there?
Yeah.
Well, Molly just threw up on it.
breed them. I'm an ordinary woman with feelings. I'd like a man to nibble on my ear, but I'll admit no man has bit. So how come I'm the mother of the year? Little cheeks, little teeth, everything around me is little. If I wring little necks, surely I will get an acquittal. Some women are dripping with diamonds, some women are dripping with pearls. Ow! Lucky me, lucky me, look at what I'm dripping with. Little girls. Each little bloomer I'd have cracked years ago if it weren't for my sense of humor. Someday I'll step on their freckles, some night I'll straighten their curls. Send a flood, send the flu, anything that you can do to
Miss Hannigan, is it?
Oh, yeah.
I'm Lieutenant Ward of the 17th Precinct. We found your runaway. You!
Oh, well, thank you, officer.
She was in one of them Hoovervilles down to the river with a bunch of bums.
They weren't bums!
Had a mangy mutt with her, but he got away.
Oh, poor little pumpkin. Out in the freezing cold with just this thin apron. Oh, I hope you didn't catch influenza. Thanks again, officer.
All in the line of duty. And you, don't let me ever hear that you run away again from this nice lady.
Oh, thank you.
Good afternoon.
Oh, good afternoon, officer. Now, I'm gonna have your head, and the next time you walk out that door, it'll be 1953. Well, are you glad to be back, huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar! What's the one thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie. Well, what's the one thing I always taught you?
Never tell a lie, Miss Hannigan.
Well, what you done, I could have got fired. Had the Board of Orphans sticking their nose in around here. Well, you'll pay for this, I promise. Stay. Yeah?
Oh, good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yeah?
Oh, good. I'm Grace Farrell.
So?
The New York City Board of Orphans.
Oh, wait a minute, hold it. I can explain everything. It wasn't my fault. It was Annie, you see, who got into Bundle's laundry bag.
Miss Hannigan,
sure, I know I should have called Mr. Donatelli instead of the cops.
Miss Hannigan, I'm sorry, but I haven't the slightest idea what you're talking about.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold it, sister. I get it. If it's beauty products you're peddling, I don't need any. Oh.
Now get out.
Miss Hannigan, I'm not peddling anything. I'm private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
Oliver Warbucks? The Oliver Warbucks?
The Oliver Warbucks. Miss Hannigan, Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays at his home, and I'm here to select one for him.
Well, are you sure that he wouldn't rather have a lady? I got 2 weeks coming.
Well,
Yeah, it's a joke. All right. What sort of orphan do you have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly. Mm. And intelligent.
Mississippi, capital MISSISSIPPI. I. Mississippi.
And cheerful.
You shut up! And how old?
Oh, age doesn't really matter. Say 8. 9, 10, 11. Yes, 11 would be perfect. And, oh, I almost forgot. Mr. Warbucks prefers red-headed children.
Eleven, a redhead. No, I'm afraid we don't have any orphans like that around here.
What about this child right here?
Annie, oh, no, you wouldn't want Annie because she is a... a drunk... and a liar! A drunk and a liar!
Yes, I'm sure she's a drunk and a liar. Annie, come here. Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' house?
Gee, I'd love to. I'd really love to.
Now, hold it! Oh. You can have any orphan in the orphanage, but not Annie.
Why?
I just told you because she's a drunk.
I assume, Miss Hannigan, that it has something to do with all that business about the laundry bag and the police. Perhaps I should call Mr. Donatelli at the Board of Orphans and tell him all about
it. I'll sign it. I'm an easy gal to get along with. If it's Annie you want, it's Annie you get.
It's Annie I want.
Oh, boy!
So... if you'll just get her coat, I'll take her along right now.
Coat? Ha! She ain't got no coat.
Well, then we'll buy her one.
Oh, boy!
We'll go to Best's and get you a warm winter coat. Come along, dear. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is waiting outside.
Oh, boy, I can hardly believe it!
She can hardly believe it.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan, and season's greetings.
Yeah, season's greetings!
Yes, I'm getting up for Christmas already. Bye!
You're all making me crazy! Get out of here! Someday I'll land in the nut house with all the nuts and the squirrels. There I'll stay tucked away till the prohibition of...
Good afternoon, Miss Farrell.
Good afternoon, Drake. Everyone?
Miss?
Has Mr. Warbucks arrived yet?
No, miss, but I called Teterboro and his flight from Chicago landed at 3:30, so we're expecting him any minute.
Do you really live here? Or is this the train station?
We really live here. Has the carpet been put down in the dining room, Mrs. Greer?
Yes, miss.
Oh, and has the Steinway been tuned?
Yes, miss.
Everything is in order, miss. Mrs. Pugh has prepared his favorite meal.
Fine. It will be good to see Mr. Warbucks again.
Yes, 6 weeks is a long time.
Yes, miss.
Now, would you all come here for a moment, please?
Quickly, everyone. Everyone, quickly.
Everyone, this is Annie. She'll be with us for the next 2 weeks for Christmas.
Miss?
Annie, this is, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear.
Gee, I really love my new coat, Miss Farrell.
I'm glad, dear. Now, Annie, what do you want to do first?
The floors. Go scrub them. Then I'll get to the windows.
Annie, you won't have to do any cleaning while you're here.
I won't?
Of course not. You're our guest. And for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time. Now, Cecile will pick out all your clothes.
Green is the best color.
Blue. Your bath is to run by Mrs. Greer.
So, no bubbles, I think.
Annette comes in to make your bed.
The silk. No, the satin sheets, I think.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
The swimming pool is to the left.
Is that the house?
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy!
The tennis court is in the rear.
I never even picked up a racket.
Oh. Have an instructor here at noon. Oh, and get that Don Budge fellow if he's available.
6 weeks. Where the hell is everybody? Hello.
Sir.
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
It's good to be home.
How was your flight from Chicago?
Not bad. Took 11 hours. We only had to land 4 times. Now, first things first, has that painting arrived from Paris?
Yes, sir. They're just about to hang it now, sir.
Ah, yes.
No, I don't think so. Grace.
Yes, sir.
Messages?
Yes, sir. Called. He wants you to call him at the White House.
I'll get back to him tomorrow. Anyone else?
John D. Rockefeller, Mahatma Gandhi, and Harpo Marx.
Nothing urgent. What did Harpo want?
He didn't say.
Oh, wait. Wait.
Perhaps I could get used to this thing. Hang it in the hall. Drake.
Yes, sir?
I'll need my smoking jacket and my brown velvet pants.
Mr. Warbucks, I'd like you to...
Oh, and Mrs. Pugh.
Yes, sir?
I won't be having dinner tonight. I have far too much paperwork to get through.
Yes, sir.
Grace.
Yes, sir.
I'll need you for dictation.
Yes, sir.
All right, it's good to see everyone.
Sir.
Drake.
Yes, sir?
Dismiss the staff.
Yes, sir.
Now, Grace, if you'll just get your notebook, come along with me. Who is that?
This is Annie, Mr. Warbucks, the orphan who'll be with us for the Christmas holidays.
The orphan? Well, that's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose a girl.
Well, I suppose you'll have to do Annie, huh? Annie what?
Sir?
What's your last name, child?
Oh, I'm just Annie, sir. Mr. Warbucks. I haven't got any last name that I know of.
So, you're just Annie, huh?
Just Annie. I'm sorry that I'm not a boy.
Well, I don't suppose you'd like to meet Lou Gehrig.
Oh, boy, sure! Who's Lou Gehrig?
I couldn't be happier that you'll be spending Christmas with us. Grace, we'll start with those figures on the iron ore shipments from Toledo to... Well, what are we supposed to do with this child?
It is her first night here, sir.
What? First night here, Annie. Well, I suppose we ought to do something special for you. What? Poofy? Oh, yeah. How would you like to go and see a movie?
Gosh, sure, Mr. Warbucks, I'd love to. I mean, I've heard a lot about them, but I've never been to one.
Never?
No, sir.
Well, we'll have to do something about that, and right away. And nothing but the best for you. You'll go to the Roxy. And then for an ice cream soda at Rumpelmeyer's. And then a handsome cab ride around Central Park.
Golly!
Grace, forget about that dictation tonight. We'll do it first thing in the morning. Instead, you take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Aw, gee.
Well, no, what's the matter, Annie?
Nothing, sir. It's just... gee.
Oh, no, no. What is it, child? You don't want to go to the Roxy?
No, I want to. It's just that I thought you were going to take me.
Me? No, no, no. I'm afraid I'll be far too busy.
Archie.
Well, Annie, I have just been away for 6 weeks making an inspection tour of my factories. Well, at least what's left of my factories with this damn depression. Darn depression. And when a man is running a multi-billion-dollar corporation...
Oh, sure. I know. That's okay, Mr. Warbucks.
Excuse me, sir. Bernard Baruch calling.
Oh, good. Hello, Barney. I just got back an hour ago. No, Detroit and Chicago. Barney, I didn't like what I saw out there. Factory shut down. Yes, my factories. You're darn tootin'. If I'm not making money, nobody is. And damn it, Barney. No, darn it, Barney. Barney, you gotta tell your pal Roosevelt he's gotta come up with a new approach, a new plan, a new... something. Yes. I know he's a Democrat, but he's a human being, too. Yeah, all right. Yes, I'll talk to you about it. Come over here tonight. Yeah, we'll be able to... I can show you the... Oh, Barney, you better make it tomorrow. Tonight, I've got a date to go to the movies with a 10-year-old girl.
11.
Yes, I was mistaken. She's 11. Bye, Barney. Drake?
Yes, sir.
Coates?
Yes, sir.
Oh, and Grace, you'll come too, of course.
Will you be wanting the Bentley, sir, or the Duesenberg?
Oh, the Duesenberg. Hey, oh, no, wait. This child has been cooped up in an orphanage. We'll walk.
Walk to the Roxy?
Sure, why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Ah. Smell that. Marvelous. Fifth Avenue bus fumes. There's no air like the air of New York. And you don't realize how much you miss it. The whole damn city. Till you've been away from it for a while. Like the man says, after New York, every place else is Gilroy. NYC. What is it about you? You're big. You're loud. You're tough. NYC. I go years without you. Then I can't get enough. Enough of cab drivers answering back in language far from pure. Enough of frankfurters answering back. Oh, brother, you know you're in NYC. Too busy, too crazy, too hot, too cold, too late. I'm sold again on NYC. Now, come on, you slow folks. We got to get to the Roxy before the prices change. Hey, nuts!
NYC!
The shadows at sundown, the roofs that skirt.
Village and the Rundown. The big parade goes by. What other town has the Empire State and a mayor 5'2"? No other town in the whole 48 can half compare to you.
O-N-Y-C.
You make them all postcards.
You crowd, you cram, you're still the champ. Amen for NYC.
The shimmer of Times Square, the pulse,
the beat, the drive.
You may think that I'm square, but damn, I come alive.
The city's bright as the penny arcade. It blinks, it tilts, it rings.
To think that I lived here all of my life and never seen these things.
NYC, the whole world keeps coming.
By bus,
by train.
I haven't had any popcorn.
Give in, don't fight, good girl.
Goodbye.
Sleep tight in NYC.
Stands for the Jell-O family. That's Jell-O, yum, yum, yum. Jell-O pudding.
Yum, yum, yum.
Jell-O tapioca pudding. Yes, sirree.
Once again, we bring you the romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove for herself what so many women long to prove, that because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life need not be over. That romance can live in life at 35 and after.
Oh, merciful God, I hope so. Doors open!
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Oh, yeah. Feral!
You're early. Only 1 week. What's the matter? Warbucks fed up with Annie already?
Oh, no. On the contrary, Mr. Warbucks is delighted with Annie, and Annie is having the time of her life.
Annie.
Oh, yes. They're practically inseparable. They go everywhere together. To the Roxy, to the Stock Exchange, and oh, guess where they had lunch yesterday?
The Waldorf.
The Automat.
The Automat.
And she just loves her new coat. She never takes it off.
Never.
Never. Miss Hannigan, I know you're busy, but this has to be signed and sent back to Mr. Donatelli at the Board of Orphans by no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
What for?
Because Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that, guess what?
What?
He wants to adopt her.
Well, how nice! How wonderful! Now let me get that wonderful news straight. Annie's gonna be Warbucks kid, the daughter of a millionaire.
Oh, no, 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 no. The daughter of a billionaire.
A billionaire.
And Mr. Warbucks asked me to drop by in person to tell you that Annie won't be coming back here. Ever.
Ever. My. Excuse me for just a moment, please. I'll be right back.
More wonderful news.
I told you about the coat, didn't I?
Oh, yeah, you told me about the coat.
Well, then, good afternoon, Miss Hannah.
Yes, good afternoon.
And, Merry Christmas.
Yeah, Merry Christmas.
Whoops. Oh, oh. Ooh, pardon me, Blondie.
But it pours. They finally let you at Leavenworth, huh?
I got 6 months off for good behavior.
I'll bet. What was it this time?
Some old geezer from Yonkers says that I swindled him out of $1,100.
Really? Now, why would he say that?
Because the rooster swindled him out of $1,100.
Lily. Sis, like you to meet a friend of mine from,
Jersey City.
Jersey City. Meet Miss Lily, St. Regis.
I'm named after the hotel.
Which floor?
Don't you just love Lil Sis?
I'm lots of butter. Rooster?
Yeah?
Do me a favor. Get out of here and take the St. Regis with you.
Come on, sis.
Can it? Looking for another handout, huh?
Nah. I got $80 coming for me in the mail. Thursday. So all I need is Chan to tide me over?
Not even a nickel for the subway, Rooster.
A fiver? Oh, Aggie!
$5? Oh, God, I gotta laugh. You with all your big talk, gonna be living in clover.
Yeah, well, this ain't exactly a Buckingham Palace.
Oh, man. Yeah? Well, I'm on the city. Steady salary, free food, free gas, and electric. I'm doing all right.
Sis, you doing like I'm doing.
Lousy.
Egg. Sheets. How'd the two Hannigan kids ever end up like this? Under skids. I remember the way our sainted mother would sit and croon us her lullaby.
She'd say, kids, there's a place that's like no other. You got to get there before you die.
You don't get there by playing from the rule book.
You stack the aces.
You load the dice.
Mother dear, oh, we know you're down there listening. How can we follow your sweet advice to?
The blondie I bump into when I came in, huh? Hey, look like she had a couple of dollars.
She works for Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks, the millionaire?
Not the billionaire, you dumb hoe. Tell.
She works for him in his mansion up there on Fifth Avenue.
Fifth Avenue? He don't live on no Fifth Avenue.
He don't? Where does he live?
Game one. Oh,
she brought me the wonderful news that Annie, one of the orphans from here.
Annie? God, I hate that kid.
She's getting adopted by Warbucks. Gonna have everything. That rotten kid is gonna have everything.
Crummy orphan, living in a lap of luxury.
It ain't fair. How we scrounge for $3 or $4
while she gets Warbucks.
That little brat.
It ain't fair. This here life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fat.
Maybe she holds the key, that little lady,
to getting more bucks.
Instead of less. Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Oh, go on, tell us.
I give you one guess.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Yes, Mr. President, I grant you that Barney Baruch and I are not exactly standing on bread lines. No, I'm not asking for your help. I've never asked for any man's help, and I never will. But I'm telling you, Mr. President, you've got to do something and do it damn fast. Yes, all right. I'll talk to you about it on...
Friday.
On Friday. Yeah, good. Listen, Mr. President, why don't we bury the hatchet? And you come on over here on Christmas Eve for supper with Mrs. Roosevelt on your way to Hyde Park. Wonderful. Goodbye, Mr. President. Damn, if I thought he was going to say yes, I never would have invited him. Grace, call Al Smith. Find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
And make a note. Friday morning, 11 a.m., meeting at the White House with President Roosevelt.
Yes, sir.
That package from Tiffany's?
Yes, sir. Arrived this morning.
Good. I'm going to give her this thing, and then I'm going to tell her I want to adopt her. Where is Annie?
In her room, sir, writing another letter to her friends at the orphanage. I'll have Drake call her.
Fine. Damn.
You don't have to be nervous, sir. She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Well, damn right she is. And I'm not nervous. I'll get her down here.
Yes, sir. Drake, Mr. Warbucks will see Annie now.
Miss Annie, Mr. Warbucks will see you now.
Thank you, Mr. Drake. Hello.
Oh. Hello, Annie. How are you today?
Fine, thank you. How are you, sir?
Fine. Thank you. Annie... time for the two of us to have a very serious discussion.
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
What? Oh, no, of course not. Annie, can we talk man to man?
Sure.
Ha! Annie, I was raised in a very poor family, what we call Hell's Kitchen right here in New York, and both of my parents died before I was 10. And I made myself a promise that one day, one way or another, I was going to be rich. Very rich.
That was a good idea.
Yes. Well, by the time I was 23, I made my first million. And then in 10 years, I turned that into 100 million. And in those days, that was a lot of money. Well, making money is all I've ever given a damn about. And I have to tell you, Annie, I was ruthless to the people I had to climb over to get to the top. Because I've always believed one thing. You don't have to be nice to the people you meet on the way up if you're not planning on coming back down again. But lately I've realized something. No matter how many Rembrandts and Duesenbergs you've got, if you have no one to share your life with, if you're alone, you might as well be broke and back in Hell's Kitchen. Annie, do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Sure!
Good.
Kind of.
Kind of?
I guess not.
Oh, damn. Oh! Annie, I was in Tiffany's yesterday, picked this thing up for you, and I had it engraved.
For me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbucks. You're so nice to me.
Yes.
Oh. Gee.
Annie, that's a silver locket. I noticed that old broken one you always wear, and I said to myself, I'm going to get that kid a nice new locket.
Gosh. Thanks, Mr. Warbucks. Thank you very much.
Well, we'll take the old one off.
No, please don't let me take my locket off. I don't want a new one.
Well, Annie, what is it? What's the matter?
This locket. My mom and dad left it with me when they left me at the orphanage. There was a note, too. They're coming back for me, you know, and I know being here with you for Christmas and all. I'm really lucky, but I don't know how to say it. The one thing I want in all the world, more than anything else, is to find my mother and father and be like other kids and folks of my own.
Well, it's all right, Annie. I'll find them for you. I'll find your mother and father. I'll go. I'll go and I'll get her a brandy.
it's going to be all right.
You'll see, Miss Annie, if anyone can find your parents, Mr. Warbucks is the man.
There's nothing to worry about, dear. Mr. Warbucks will find your mother and father if he has to put everyone in his organization on the job, if he has to pull every political string that there is to pull, up to and including the White House.
The League of Nations!
If he should need the FBI, then he will have the FBI.
With all the favors that he's done, J. Edgar Hoover owes him one.
Where other men would call him quits and disappear, he leaves his fortune and his wits. Never, never fear, cross the street, across the sea, and his sweet, we guarantee that you won't be an orphan. No, you won't be an orphan for long.
Hey, Edgar, Warbucks. Yes, I want 50 of your best G-men. Well, a day, a week, a month, however long it takes, just put them on vacation. I'll pay for it. No, no, I'll pay all costs. Fine. When can I have them? Well, tomorrow morning. Good. Oh, and Jay, I want Gunderson. Well, you just take him off of the Dillinger case. Hip, hip, hooray! Give me your locket.
Well, Mr. Works, I told you...
No, I understand, my dear, but it could be our best clue. We'll give it to the FBI to trace where it was bought and then find out who bought it.
Oh, well, maybe you should have my note, too.
Oh, you watch, my dear. We could be finding your parents in a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh, boy, I gotta write a letter to the kids about this.
What a thing to occur, finding them, losing her. Oh, you won't be an orphan for long.
And Mr. Warbucks says that I'm going to be meeting my mother and father within a couple of days. So maybe now it's time, and maybe when I wake, they'll be there calling me.
Thank you, Annie. On America's favorite radio program, The Occident Hour of Smiles, starring your old softie, Burke Healy. A moment of tears.
Thank you, Burke Healy.
But still remember, folks, smile, darn ya, smile. Right, wacky smile, darn ya, smile.
Say, who's that who just walked into our WEAF studio?
Why, it's none other than that wealthy industrialist and Wall Street tycoon, Oliver Warbucks.
Good evening, Oliver Warbucks. It's nice of you to drop by.
Good evening, Bert Healy. It's nice to be here.
Oliver Warbucks, I understand that you have something to tell the folks at home about Wonder Little Annie here.
Yes, Annie is an 11-year-old foundling who was left by her parents on the steps of New York's municipal orphanage on the night of December 31st, 1922.
And aren't you now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents?
Yes, Bert Healy, I am now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. And furthermore, I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 to any persons who can prove that they are Annie's parents.
Wow!
$50,000? Wow, Oliver Warbucks.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy! 50,000 smackers!
Shh, quiet, Wacky. This is no joke.
I know, Mr. McCracken. Everything you say is no joke. And you move your lips, too.
Ha, ha, ha,
ha. So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station, WEAF, New York, or directly to him at...
At my home, Bert Healy, 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York. Drop page.
That's 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York. Thank you, Oliver Warbucks.
Thank you, Bert Healy. And I would like to take this opportunity to thank the makers of Occident Toothpaste with Miracle K64 to fight bad breath for letting me be here tonight. Good night, Bert Healy. Bad breath.
Good night, Oliver Warbucks.
Thank you.
So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, there's $50,000 and a wonderful daughter waiting for you.
So, get in touch right away, you hear?
Well, I can see by the old clock on the wall that another one of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say, Occident.
O-X-Y-E-N-T.
The toothpaste of the stars, to make your teeth Hollywood bright. So for the entire Hour of Smiles family, Ronnie, Bonnie, and Connie, the Boylan sisters, Fred McCracken,
and Wacky,
and Jimmy Johnson, radio's only masked announcer.
This is Bert Healy saying, hey, hobo man, hey, dapper Dan, you both got your style, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be Beau Brummel-y, they stand out a mile, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Who cares what they're wearing on Main Street or Savile Row? It's what you wear from ear to ear, and not from head to toe, that matters.
So
senator,
so
janitor,
so
long for a while, remember, you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Ready or not, here he goes. Listen to Bert have a smile and toes.
The lovely Boylan sisters.
Your clothes may be Beau Brummel-y, they stand not a mile, but probably you're never fully dressed. You're never dressed without a smile. Smile, darn ya.
Yes, this is your old sock the Mrs. Healy's boy, Bert. Saying until next week, same time, same station. Bonsoir, buenas noches, good night, buenas era. And oh, I almost forgot.
$50,000. Oh, God, I hate that Annie so much you'd think I was her mother.
Pardon me, ma'am, but are you the lady that runs this here orphanage?
Yeah, what do you want?
Oh, Ralph, I'm scared. Something could have happened to her.
Hush, Shirley. She's gonna be here, and she's gonna be ours again. Pardon me, ma'am, but was you working here 11 years ago?
Yeah.
Well, we run into trouble back then, and we had to head up north to Canada. We had to leave a baby here on the front stoop.
Our little girl. Our Annie.
Annie? You're Annie's parents?
Yes, ma'am, we are.
Please, nothing's happened to her.
And his church. Where'd you say it comes from again?
We come from a little farm up north where there are plenty of chickens.
And geese.
And ducks.
And sheep.
And roosters.
I never would have known it was you in a million years.
Fooled ya, Aggie. And we're gonna fool that Warbucks, too.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones!
This is gonna be the best bunco job ever, Aggie. I know a guy out in Brooklyn that can doctor up a fake birth certificate or any other paper you want. But we're gonna need your help, sis. For details about any that can help us pull this thing off.
Sure. I could help you. A lot. But what's in it for me, Ralph?
A three-way split!
Half.
Half! All right, half! Straight down the middle, 25 grand each, all right? But we gotta do it fast. Give him some of the old rooster razzle-dazzle, in and out. 2-3 minutes at the most. Then we get the money, we get the girl, and we get the hell out of town.
Oh, yeah, the kid. Annie. That's the problem. What would we do with her afterwards?
Sis, that's no problem. When I want something to disappear, it disappears. For good. So we get the 50 grand. We blow this crummy town, and then Lil and me will meet you.
Where?
Oh, yeah!
Easy Street! Easy Street! Annie is the key! Yes, sirree! Yes, sirree! Yes, sirree! Move the feet to Easy Street! That's where we're gonna! That's where we're gonna! That's where we're gonna!
Stay! I'm coming, Mama! Yeah!
From Franklin Delano Roosevelt and his so-called brain trust is a great deal of high-flown talk and virtually no action. In a nation racked by poverty, misery, and unemployment, it is deeds we want from the White House, not words. In short, Mr. President, if you are listening, we've had enough of your fireside chats. It is time to...
Criticism, damn it! Nothing but criticism!
Oh, I know!
It's awful!
Did anyone see the Washington Post this morning?
My friends, I say it again. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Oh, yes.
Every cloud has a silver lining.
Please.
You're never fully dressed without a smile.
Frank.
All right.
Oliver Warbucks and friend, Franklin.
Thank you, Lewis. Show them in. Now, Oliver, good of you to have come.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Where? Who is this we have here?
Mr. President, this is my good friend, Annie. She wanted so much to meet you, I couldn't resist bringing her along just to say hello.
Annie, of course. The little girl who sang so beautifully on the radio last night.
Annie, this is President Roosevelt.
How do you do, President Roosevelt?
How do you do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sounded on the radio.
Thank you, President Roosevelt.
Well, since we're all here...
Yes, Annie, if you'll just wait outside.
No, no, Oliver, let Annie stay. Having a child on hand will keep us on our best behavior.
Thank you, Mr. President. Annie?
Harold, I don't want to hear even so much as a gosh out of you. Oliver, you know everyone, of course. But Annie, let me introduce you. Secretary of Labor, Perkins. Secretary of State, Hull. Acting Secretary of the Treasury, Morgenthau. Secretary of the Interior, Ickes. Say hello, Harold.
Hello.
And my friend and aide, Mr. Lewis Howe. Now, Oliver, since you speak for those happy few Americans who have any money left, I'd like to begin with your view on matters.
Mr. President, in the words of Calvin Coolidge,
yes,
the business of this country is business. And for the good of the country and the good of you, the good of Wall Street and the good of me, we have to get my factories open again and the workers back to work.
According to my latest figures, there are now 15 million Americans out of work and nearly 50 million with no visible means of support.
Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our greatest problem. The dispatches from Germany are becoming more and more disturbing each day. There could be war.
Germany, hell! People are starving in this country.
Harold, I know that, but in the long run...
Odell, for people who are starving, there is no long run.
The trouble is, it's all happening at once. Wall Street's taken another nosedive.
Sit-down strikes, riots, floods, dust.
And the FBI still hasn't caught Dillinger.
Well, at least we're agreed on one thing. The situation is hopeless and getting worse.
The Senate come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow they'll be signed.
Quiet, little girl! Harold!
What did you say, Annie? Well, that's all right. Go ahead, my dear. It's still a free country.
Just thinking about tomorrow. Clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just think of my chin. The sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're always a day away.
Harold Ickes, stand up.
What?
You heard me, stand up. Now, Harold, sing.
Sing?
Yes, sing, like Annie here. I've just decided that if my administration is going to be anything, it's going to be optimistic about the future of this country. Now, sing.
But really, Franklin, you know that I can't...
Sing!
The sun will come out tomorrow.
Louder,
Harold. Get your bottom dollar that tomorrow. There'll be some...
Perkins?
Just thinking about tomorrow. And the sorrow till there's none.
Solo for the president. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say, my friends, everyone, Republicans to all of us, sing!
The sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may.
President, a telegram.
Yes, of course. Excuse me, everyone. Oh, this isn't for me. It's for you, Oliver, from your secretary in New York. Hundreds of couples jamming street outside house claiming to be Annie's parents. I've begun to interview them. Suggest you return New York at once. Signed, Grace Faddle.
Well, it looks as though the Hour of Smiles has more listeners than we thought. Huh, Annie?
Gee. Hundreds of couples. One of them is bound to be my mother and father.
Well, Oliver, as much as I'm enjoying your company, and especially yours, Annie, I suspect you'd better get back to New York at once.
Yes, if you don't mind, Mr. President, Annie.
Goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye, Annie.
Goodbye, Mr. President, and thank you.
No, thank you, Annie. You're the kind of person a president should have around him.
Mr. President?
What if we set up 100 or 1,000 federal projects?
Dams.
Highways.
New post offices.
And put the unemployed to work building them.
We could create over 5 million new jobs within 6 months.
And weekly paychecks would get those millions off relief and back to paying taxes.
We'll build a country so strong that nobody, not even Chancellor Hitler, could ever beat us in a war.
And the FBI caught Babyface Nelson, didn't they? They're bound to catch Dillinger.
Mr. President, what we've got to give this country is nothing less than a new outlook.
A new vision.
A new approach.
A new concept.
A new dedication.
A new horizon.
A new spirit.
A new attitude.
A new deal! Perkins, gentlemen, I was right the first time. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you. Tomorrow, you're only a day away. Harmony.
Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you. Tomorrow, you're only a day.
Farrell, I'm afraid there's still no sign of Mr. Warbucks and Miss Annie.
Drake, look at all these questionnaires. Do you realize that I've talked to 627 women who claim to be Annie's mother and 619 men who said that they were her father? That makes, let's see...
1,246.
All liars. Drake, I never realized that there were so many dishonest people on the island of Manhattan.
Some of them were from the Bronx, miss.
Rish! We're back.
Where are they, Miss Farrell? Where are all the people?
Gone, dear. Come and gone. I'm sorry, Annie, but they were all liars and fakes after nothing but the $50,000.
Oh, gee.
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry.
I was sure somebody was going to be my mother and father.
Sir, this just came by special messenger from the FBI.
Ah, finally. Yes, Agent Gunderson has located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh, my!
That sort of locket was manufactured between 1918 and 1924.
Sort of locket?
Yes. Over 90,000 were made and sold.
Oh, gee.
Oh, Annie. I'm afraid the gist of it is that Gunderson doesn't think there's a chance in a million of tracing your parents through this locket. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I mean, gee, you did the best you could. If you can't find them, nobody can. Anyway, I guess a kid can get along without folks. You didn't turn out so bad. You got everything. All them Duesenbergs hanging on the wall.
Excuse us, Mr. Warbucks. We'll go check on the dinner menu.
Yes, Annie, a Duesenberg is a car. And Lou Gehrig is the first baseman for the New York Yankees. And there's something else you should know. I made me a fortune. That fortune made 10. Been headlined and profiled again and again. But something was missing, I never quite knew. That something was someone, but who? My speeches were greeted with thunderous acclaim at 2 universities bearing my name. But something was missing each time I got through. That something was someone, but who? Who could that someone be? How could she make it known? Who could need me for me? The world was my oyster, but where was the pearl? Who dreamed I could find it in one little girl? Yes, something was missing, but dreams do come true. That something is no one but you. In one little girl. Yes, something was missing, but dreams do come true. That something is no one but you. Grace!
Yes, sir?
Grace, do you have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Yes, sir! I'll get them right away!
Oh, no, wait! Grace, I would like for you to stay for a moment. I haven't waltzed since the inauguration of William Howard Taft! Yes, sit down, Annie. Annie! I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't help my grandmother and father, there's no one else in the world I'd rather have for a father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Oh, Drake, call Justice Brandeis and have him come over here to sign the adoption papers.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Grace.
Yes, sir.
Tell Mrs. Pugh there'll be a house full of guests. Now, we'll need flowers, caviar, and champagne.
And cheese.
Cheese?
Yes, cheese. You know, cheese!
Cheese? Oh, Annie, this isn't going to be an adoption. It's going to be a celebration. And you can invite anybody in the world that you want to come to it. Now, who would you like? Andrew Mellon? Madam Shankai Shank? Oh, how about Lou Gehrig?
Anyone in the world?
Yes.
Well, I guess I'd like Miss Farrell here. And Mr. Drake and Miss Farrell and Molly. I guess I'd like everybody here.
Well, of course. That's who I'd like too. Drake.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, tell the staff to get spiffed up. They're going to be guests at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
And the kids.
The kids? Oh, no, no. I'm afraid it'll be way past their bedtime. But I'll tell you what. We'll have everybody from the orphanage over here tomorrow for a great big Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Yeah, Miss Hannigan, too. Why not? Oh, Annie, I am the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid.
Together at last. Together forever. We're tying a knot they never can sever. I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue.
I don't need anything but you.
You wrap me around that cute little finger. You made life a song. You made me the singer.
And what's that bad thing to you always? Ba-ba-boo.
Ba-ba-ba anything but you.
Yesterday was plain awful.
You can say that again.
Yesterday was plain awful.
that.
Not now.
That's it.
I'm poor as a mouse.
I'm richer than Midas. But nothing on earth could ever divide us. And if tomorrow I'm an apple seller too, I don't need anything but you.
Excuse me, sir. Everyone is spiffed up for the party.
Oh, good, good. Grace!
Yes, sir?
I think Annie and I should get spiffed up, too. Would you have an it?
My Grace, that was a very pretty dress.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, yes. Have Annette put on into one of her new dresses and have Cecile do something with her hair and, well, I don't know, take her upstairs and, you know, gussy her up.
Oh. Yes, sir. Gussy her up.
Gussy her up.
Gussy her up. Gussy her up. Rockefeller got barrels of money. We got Eddie.
Everything's humming now.
Big promoter got MC and Tony. We got Eddie.
Good times are coming now.
Goodness got swing. Big is the king by far. Modest got Jeff. Eleanor FDR.
And on the radio,
we ain't got Molly, the Fiddle McGee got. George is crazy, don't look at what we got. We got better, cause we got who we got. Annie.
For us, feeling flatter than old Cesarilla. Go get Annie.
Turn on the fun for us. Have they sent the cheese?
Yes, and ice, camembert, and breeze.
Judge Brandeis.
Annie, Annie, you filled our life with a song.
My friends, this is the happiest night of my life!
We're ready to begin. The adoption process
sir.
Is quite simple.
Yes,
sir.
Excuse us, folks. Surely, look, there's our Annie.
Who are you?
Honey, we're your mom and dad.
Mudge. Mudge is the name. Ralph Mudge, and this here's the wife, Shirley.
You never knew it, dear, but you're Annie Mudge.
Annie. Mudge?
We were sick and broke, and we didn't know which way to turn, but a man gave us a chance to work up on his farm up in Canada.
But we couldn't bring along no baby.
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
Mr. Mudge, is it? We've seen a great number of people who've all
proof.
Claimed...
Proof. I expect you wanting some proof of who we are. Well, here are our driver's licenses, and here's Annie's birth certificate.
Baby girl... Name Ann Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, New York, New York, October 28th, 1922.
October 28th, that's my birthday.
It was in her notes, sir.
Yes, I know, but I still don't...
Mr. See... Please, you got to believe us. We got in on the Greyhound this afternoon. We went straight to the orphanage to fetch our Annie. The lady there said our baby was up here.
Oh, Annie... All these years, I've dreamed of holding you in my arms again.
Mr. Mudge, on the night that Annie was left at the orphanage...
Here's something that you wouldn't know about. But when we left Annie at the orphanage, we also left half of a silver locket with her. And we kept the other half, so...
Ralph, look, Annie's wearing it.
And here's the part that we kept. Yep, it fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph, she's really our Annie.
Yeah, she seems to be.
She is. She is. Well, if you'll be getting Annie's things together, we'll be taking her along.
Taking her?
No!
Just a minute, Mr. Mudge. What about the money?
Money? Well, we ain't got much, but we'd be glad to give you whatever...
No, no, no. You haven't heard that I've offered a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they are Annie's parents?
No, sir. We never heard nothing about no check. Anyway, we don't want no money.
Right. We don't want no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Cheryl, remember that little pig farm out in New Jersey? Why, with $50,000, we could afford to bring Annie up right in the country. Fresh air. Fresh eggs.
Fresh ham.
Fresh ham. Certified, huh? All I gotta do is just make it out to myself?
Yes, that's correct. Tomorrow morning?
Tomorrow morning?
Yes. You don't mind if Annie stays here until tomorrow, Christmas? Then you come back and pick up Annie and the check.
Oh.
Oh. Yes. Well, whichever you prefer, sir. So, I guess we'll be getting back to our hotel then. Yep. Bye, Annie.
Goodbye, Annie, love.
Until tomorrow morning then, honey. And you'll be spending the rest of your life with us. Well, goodbye, all. See, oh, pardon me, Blondie. Merry Christmas.
Season's greetings.
Yeah. Yes. Oh, well, this is wonderful news.
Yes.
Annie has found her parents, and they seem to be a very nice couple.
Lovely.
Oh, yes,
nice.
They seem wonderful.
You're lucky, Annie.
Right. I'm lucky. Just think. New Jersey.
Great.
Yes, sir.
Champagne.
Yes, sir.
We must celebrate, because tonight is Christmas Eve, and we have just had the most wonderful news in the world. Annie has found her mother and her... father. My friends, I propose a toast to Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge.
Annie!
Oh. Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas.
I seem to have the same effect on everyone.
I've lost her. I've lost Annie.
Sir, that Mr. Mudge, I think I've seen him someplace before. I just can't remember where or when, but I have the strangest feeling that he's not who he says he is.
Mr. President, Franklin, I need your help.
Of course, Oliver. Whatever I can do to help you.
Merry Christmas, Annie.
Merry Christmas, Annie.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Warbucks, Miss Farrell.
You're up early.
Yes, well, my folks are coming for me, of course. So I thought I'd just wait for them here. I guess they'll be taking me out to the country. Will you come and see me sometimes?
I'll see you, Annie.
You're up early, too.
Oh, we've been up all night here. We've had quite a time of it with the FBI. Men coming and going. Annie, did you know that President Roosevelt is here?
Really?
Yes, I have something very difficult to say to you, and the president is going to help me say it to you.
Merry Christmas, President Roosevelt.
Merry Christmas, Annie. It's good to see you again.
Good to see you too, sir.
Franklin.
Annie, early this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. Through the paper and the handwriting on your note, he succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, we already know that. Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
No, dear, they aren't your parents. Your parents are David and Margaret Bennett.
David and Margaret Bennett? Where are they?
Annie, your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
You mean they're dead?
Yes, dear.
So I'm an orphan after all. Like the other kids at the orphanage.
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes. Because, you see, I guess I always knew that my folks were dead. Because I knew they loved me. And they would have come back for me if they weren't.
I love you, Annie Bennett.
And I love you, too.
Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
That a girl! Who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
The birth certificate could easily have been forged, but the thing is, they knew about the locket.
The locket, that's your key.
Well, yes, but no one knew about the locket except us, and the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Ah, Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to meet you.
Oh, same here. I'd know you anywheres. You're the Oliver Warbucks, right?
Yes. Miss Hannigan, allow me to introduce you to everyone. You know my secretary, Miss Farrell, of course.
Uh-huh.
And this is the President of the United States.
Yeah, sure.
And this is my butler, Drake.
Who'd want to live in this dump?
Look, kids, there's presents here for all of us.
Oh, my goodness!
Sir, this just came from the FBI.
Good. Ha! Comes the dawn. Now it all fits together.
Annie, come look at this.
Leaping lizards! Who would have guessed?
Sir, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
Ah, show them in, Drake.
With pleasure, sir.
Franklin, would you like Drake to call for your car?
No. Eleanor can wait.
Won't you please come in, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge?
Good morning. Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
There she is, sir, the little girl.
Your little girl.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Well, we don't want to bother you folks on Christmas and all. We just come to pick up our Annie in her suitcase. And the check.
Oh, the check. I almost forgot. Here you are, Mr. Mudge. $50,000 certified.
Certified. Paid to the order of Ralph Mudge.
Read it again.
Paid to the order of...
The jig is up!
Yes, the jig is up, Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as...
Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dip!
Franklin, I believe that fraud is a federal offense and that your Secret Service agents have the power to arrest...
Yes, Oliver, they do. Lewis, turn them over.
Yes, sir.
Bye, Mom. Bye, Dad.
Dad!
and you'll find this woman their accomplice. Arrest her too, please.
Me? Why, I never seen these people till yesterday.
Oh, come on, Fanaggy.
Yes, sis. If Lily and me's taking the vows, who's you?
Mr. Warbucks. Oliver, why, I ain't done nothing to you. I always been
the
kind
of... up!
Annie, honey, tell him how good and nice I always been to you.
Gee, I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan, but remember the one thing you always taught me. Never tell...
Never tell.
Never tell a lie.
Brat! Well, I'm gonna let you in on a secret. I never liked you, you little gold digger. Never liked any of yous, either. Ugh, you're manhandling me. Are you married?
Annie, we'd like to meet your friends.
Kids! Kids, I'd like you to meet Miss Grace Farrell.
Hello!
Hi, kids.
And this is Mr. Daddy Warbucks.
Hello!
Hi, kids.
Oh, and this is the President of the United States.
Hello!
Hiya, kids!
Listen, kids, I got great news. Miss Hannigan's gone for good.
Yay!
Yes, and you won't have to work anymore.
Yay!
Instead, you'll have classrooms and teachers.
Yay!
Listen, kids, no more mush.
Yay!
Yes, kids, for you, and perhaps for all of us, this Christmas is going to be the beginning of a wonderful new life. I know the depression's depressing.
The carols are stilled, the stores aren't filled.
And windows are minus their dressing.
The children don't grin, the Santas are thin.
And I've heard a terrible rumor. No goodwill, no cheer. But we'll get a new deal for Christmas this year.
The snowflakes are bright in the fall.
And all across the land, folks are bawling.
And filled with despair, cause cupboards are bare.
But Santa's got brand new assistants. There's nothing to fear. We're getting a new deal for Christmas this year.
On Farley and Perkins! On Ickes and Wallace! On Morgenthau and Cummings!
Fill the pockets with dollars!
On Morgan and Swanson!
Get along, Cordell Hall!
Get along,
Hall. Call your committee up!
Build every city up!
Cheer every kitty up!
Fill every stocking with laughter!
We have a room! Rain for boom! Let's ring every bell from its rafter!
And chime across the land! Happy days that we were promised are finally here!
We're here.